Guys, here it is. You know, they killed the Keystone pipeline, so we know that the Dakota Access pipeline is going to be next. That's going to go too. And they're interviewing these poor people that have lost these big paying jobs. You know, they migrated to these states to get these jobs because of the economic situation in the states they came from, which of course built up the economy and these kind of no population, nothing going on, cities and areas of the state, which when these workers go and that work goes, then all those jobs and all that housing and all the things that were benefited by the communities financially, all that goes away when these workers go away. Which, so this is going to be billions and billions and billions of dollars. So, you know, we got all this money now. We're letting all the MS-13 and everybody that's supposed to be deported, we're going to hold that for 100 days. We're going to give all these illegals all this free health care and free every freaking thing else. So why don't we start off with these displaced oil workers? And why doesn't the federal government stroke every one of them a check for $1 million? Because they took their career away. These were high-paying jobs. I mean, you see some of these people. Yeah, I'm 64, but you see some of these people. You know, they're 45, 55, and up. And I got news for you. When you go out and you try to find a new job in a different line of work, and say you've been making some ridiculous six-figure salary, they're just going to laugh at you, you know, and they say, hey, we got $15 an hour for you. And you're going to say, huh? Gonna say, what the hell happened here? You've destroyed me. Same, because the exact thing happened to me during the financial collapse. I had to restructure my job, right? Because my employer cut back, so I was gone, and I had to take a job and start over again at half the pay I was making. And I said, man, that's all starting pay here is now. And they said, yeah, and we're hiring you. And just remember, be grateful you can. Be grateful for that. Be grateful you're even getting a new job. A lot of people aren't. And I said, yeah, you're right. It's just a shame to see that due to mismanagement in the Obama administration, I had to go from $20 an hour down to $10.50. And of course, I never was able to build that back up again because I had too many things in. Plus, I lost my 6% 401k match. I lost my time and a half after 8 hours, time and a half on the weekend, whether it was over 40 hours or not. I lost triple time and a half on a holiday. I lost all those things for a straight $10 an hour. And that was thanks to good old Barack Obama and the Vice President Joe Biden. And they're going after it again. Right, so this is just going to be horrible. What's going to happen to places and communities? You know, like especially around the Dakota Access Pipeline, there's little small towns and stuff that are all built up now. The people have, there's been a lot of money made by the merchants and stuff, and all that's going to go away to nothing. And they're going to go out of business, and they're not going to come back. So cut these businesses $1 million check. And the other thing is, we figured it out now, or someone figured it out and told me. These restaurants, I don't know what's involved in getting approval for a lotto machine in each state, but these restaurants that can't be open and things that are being curtailed, and people wondered why liquor stores were open, but they couldn't open their restaurant or they couldn't open their hair salon. It's because a liquor store has a lotto machine and the state wants that income. So anything, and look around, anything with a lotto machine in your state is open and it's deemed an essential business and it's open 24/7. So all the hair salon needs or all the small restaurant needs, if they're catching hell out where they're at, is just apply and get a lotto machine and all of a sudden they'll be an essential business. So hey, with that tidbit of information, I'm out.